Talk about how to install add-ins in PowerPoint 2016. So first of all, why you need add-ins and what they are. So if you see the office bar of my PowerPoint, then you can find in the end that here is another tab here, add-ins. You might not find this add-ins tab if you have not a single add-in installed in your inside your PowerPoint. So if I click this tab, then you can see that I have this custom toolbar here with these kind of buttons. So that is an additional add-in which is installed by another third-party application called Camtasia Studio. So when I was installing Camtasia Studio, it asked me if I want to install a PowerPoint add-in. So I checked that and installed, and after that I get this add-in. So that is a functionality which was not available inside PowerPoint. So after installing a third party application, I get this functionality within the PowerPoint, because that Camtasia also created an add-in. So you can use the functionality of Camtasia recorder inside PowerPoint without running any of these two applications. So let me tell you more about add-ins. So as we have this animation, that will be my next tutorial, that how to create this kind of animation in PowerPoint 2016. So before creating this animation, you must have a little bit knowledge about add-ins so you can create this kind of animation. Let me show you the preview first. So as you can see that this monkey is floating in the air, but if you see the animations, then you can notice that is a little bit difficult to create in PowerPoint 2016, and let me tell you why. So as a monkey float in the air, you can see that the legs has the spin effect, and the arms has spin effect, and the ear also has the spin effect. Then you can notice a third eye here which get visible. There has been a few effects has been applied on the eyes as well. The another thing that you should notice in this animation is the cloth of the monkey. So if we discuss about these animation, then you can count down the number of the animation that has been applied on a single object, like this left leg. First of all, it moves to up with a motion path, then it starts spinning, then it is also floating in the air up and down. So you can imagine that how many motion paths has been applied with the spin effect. So that is why I need an add-in to apply this animation. So I will tell you in this tutorial that how to install add-ins inside PowerPoint. So as I was searching for motion path add-ins in Google, so I find out this website skp.mvps.org, and then when I click this, then I get this add-in for PowerPoint 2016. So here you can notice what this add-in can do. It can do two kind of things. It can motion path and positions. And what that means, it will create duplicate shapes at the position where each of the selected motion path animation ends. Using this tool, you can quickly determine the end position of the animation at the design time. So I will let you know about this feature after we install the add-in first. So to download this add-in, if you have 2002 or 2003 version, then you can download this zip file. Otherwise, you can go for 2007 to 2010. Even I am installing this add-in inside 2016. So I will download it right from here. A very small add-in, 95 KB. So I click this arrow and open show in folder. Right click, extract to motion path if you have WinRAR or WinZip. Otherwise, if you don't have these application, then Windows has an inbuilt functionality to extract all the files from within the compressed folder. So I am going to click here, extract to motion path folder, and you can see that it has this file. So we are not going to open this file from right here. I will go close all these windows. So to install the add-in, go to the file menu, then click options, then click on add-ins. Here choose PowerPoint add-ins from the manage drop down button and click go. So before doing this, you should also notice that go to the trust center and click trust center settings, and you must enable all macros for add-ins to run properly. So after enabling this, go to add-ins, click PowerPoint add-ins and click go and click add new. And here you need to find out the path where you have downloaded the add-in in the previous step. So we have the download folder, and here under motion path, that is the add-in, hit OK and then click close. So you can now find a new tab here, that is tools. It is available now because you have installed that add-in, and that add-in automatically added a new tab inside your PowerPoint with two new functionality, end position and align or join. So let me tell you about the end position only in this tutorial, because let's say you have this head and I have applied a few motion path to this head only. So I am going to open the selection pan, and here I am going to hide all and will make the face visible only. Sorry. So here we have the face alone. So if I go to the animations tab and open the then you can see the paths that I have defined here. So let's say I open the animation pane and delete all these paths. So let's say I apply a motion path to this animation. Let's say down motion path. So what is the end position of this object here is right here. But as soon as you will close the animation pane or move to any another tab, that will hide the stop position of the object that you were seeing before. So it is only visible when you select the animation itself. So after moving this object to this position, if you want to move it further from this position to any other location, then you don't have any idea that where this object will actually fall. I mean to say, if you make a duplicate of this object, then you will not get the exact position where you should drop this object. And if I run the slideshow, then you can see that it is not possible to match the exact position of the same object. That is why this add-in can be used. So what it will do after selecting the object having a motion path, if you go to tools and click end position, and here you can choose that which motion path you want to apply the motion path tool effect. So that is the face. So here I select the face from the list and hit the OK key. So what it is going to do, it is going to replicate the same object at the position where the motion path is ending, right here. So if I play the slideshow, exactly on top of the previous object. So then what you can do, it will replicate the object, as you can see that you have two objects with the same name. So on what you can do, you can now cut this object, add a new slide to your presentation and paste that object on the second slide. Let me apply the same background color, apply to all. Now on the second slide, you can apply the next motion path as you want or any other effect. Let me apply another motion path, left, hit OK. So what we have now is, if I run the slideshow from the first slide, so from the first slide it is going to move down at this position, and if you want to move it the same object to any other location from the second slide, then you can notice the exact position. So that is what this add-in is used for. But that add-in didn't solve the problem that I was facing in this presentation while creating the up-down animation. So I will tell you about this animation in my next tutorial. You can get more features inside your PowerPoint. The functionalities which are not available in PowerPoint, created by third parties, you can add those functionality inside PowerPoint, and you can use these features to create impressive presentations. So I hope you will like this tutorial. Let me know by liking, sharing and commenting on this video, and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a great day.